Glory to you, O giver of light. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill among all people. We praise you, we bless you, we worship you, we glorify you, we give thanks to you for your great glory. O Lord, Heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, Only Begotten Son, Lord Jesus Christ, and Holy Spirit, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You who take away the sin of the world, receive our prayer. You who sit at the Father's right, and have mercy on us. For only you are the Holy One, only you are the Lord Jesus Christ. To the glory of God the Father, amen. Every day will I bless you, I will praise your name forever. To the ages of ages, count us worthy, Lord, of passing this day without sin. Blessed are you, O Lord, God of our fathers. Your name is praised and glorified forever. Amen. Let your mercy descend upon us, O Lord, for we place your hope in you. Blessed are you, O Lord, blessed are you. Teach me your commandments. Blessed are you, O Lord, blessed are you. Teach me your commandments. Blessed are you, O Lord, blessed are you. Teach me your commandments. You have been our refuge, Lord, from one generation to the next. I cried out, Lord, have mercy on me. Heal my soul, for I have sinned against you. I run to you, O Lord. Teach me to please you, for you are my God. For in you is the fountain of life, and in your light we see light. Pour forth your mercy on those who know you, Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God,
it's time for the Lord's
Holy Mighty.
Blessed is our God always, now and forever, to the age of ages. Amen. May the Lord guide your steps to every good work. May the Lord our God remember you both in his kingdom always, now and ever, to the age of ages. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill among all.
Have mercy on us. Glory to the Father,
O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall show forth your praise.
Now and ever, O Lord, open my lips,
and my mouth shall show forth your praise.
Holy Immortal, have mercy.
Standing in the temple, we feel as though in heaven, O Theotokos, heavenly gate, open for us the door of your tender mercy.
Has come to all the world. Let us sing to him who rose from the grave, the very source of our life. By his own death, he destroyed death, bestowing on us victory and his great mercy.
Ευλογής ον δέσποτας.
Ευλογημένη βασιλεία του Πατρός. Blessed is the kingdom of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever and to the ages of ages.
Amen. Εν ειρήνη του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Υπέρ της άνωθεν ειρήνης και της σωτηρίας των ψυχών ημών του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Υπέρ της ειρήνης του σύμπαντος κόσμου, ευσταθίας των Αγίων του Θεού Εκκλησιών και της των πάντων ενώσεως του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν.
Κύριε ελέησον.
For this holy house and for those who enter it with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For pious and orthodox Christians, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Archbishop Alexius, for the honorable priesthood, for the diaconate in Christ, and for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our country, for the president, and for all in public service, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the holy and great Church of Christ, for this holy metropolis, for this parish and city, for every city and land, and for the faithful who live in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For favorable weather, for an abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who travel by land, sea, and air, for the sick, the suffering, the captives, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Commemorating our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady,
God, the Theotokos and ever-Virgin Mary,
with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life unto Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
For to you belong all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name.
Tes presbies is Theotokos, o Theos onimon.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits.
Through the intercessions of the Theotokos, Savior, save us.
The Lord has established his throne in the heavens, and his kingdom ruleth over all.
Tes presbies is Theotokos, sotes os onima.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Come in our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever-Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life unto Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
For yours is the dominion, the kingdom, and the power and glory of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, my soul. I will praise the Lord throughout my life. I will praise him as long as I have breath.
Sosoni marsi efeu, o anastas eknekon, salondasi alleluia.
Blessed whose help is the God of Jacob, whose hope is in the Lord his God.
Save us, O Son of God, who rose from the dead. Save us who sing to you, alleluia.
The Lord reigns until the ages of ages. Your God, O Zion, from one generation to the next.
Sosoni masi efeu, o anastas eknekron, salondasi alleluia. Δόξα Πατρί και Υιόν και Αγίον Πνεύματι και νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Ο μονογεννήσιος και λόγος του Θεού αθάνατος υπάρχον και κατανεξάμενος διά την ημετέραν σωτηρία σακωθήνε εκ της Αγίας Θεοτόκου εα υπαθένου Μαρίας ανθρέκος εν ανθρωπίσας σταυρωθήστε Χριστέ ο Θεός θανάτων θάνατων αγίσας. Ίσον της Αγίας Διάδος, την δοξαζόμενος το Πατρί και το Άγιο Πνεύματι.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Come, Mary, most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life unto Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
For you are a good and loving God, and you we give glory to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Master and Lord our God, you establish in heaven the order of hate.
When you
descend, grant that your holy angels may enter with together and may glorify your goodness.
Lord,
for to be the glory, honor, worship, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Immortal life, then did you mortify Hades by the lightning flash of your divinity. Also, when you raised the dead from the nether world, all the powers of the heavens were crying out, O giver of life, Christ our God, glory to you.
Sophia, Orthi.
Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ our Lord. Save us, O Son of God, risen from the dead.
We sing to you, alleluia. Ότε κάτι είπες προς τον θάνατον, η ζωή αθάνατος, τότε τον αντιενήκρωσας, τι ασλαπής της θεότητος. Ότε δε και τους τεθνεθός τας εκ των κρατός αθωνίων αίσθησας. Πάσε δυναμής των επουρανίων εκραυγαζών, ζώθω το Χριστέ ο Θεός ημών δόξασι.
Magnific- Magnificent are the accomplishments of faith. The three holy servants greatly rejoiced as they stood in the fountain of fire, as if beside still waters. And prophet Daniel appeared to the shepherd of lions as they were sheep. At their entreaties, O Christ our God, save our souls.
St. Peter's companion and sacred partner were you, and servant of Christ the Logos and his herald most wise, O holy Apostle Mark. You, O inspired mystic of the heavens recorded, for all of us the Savior's most divine holy gospel. Therefore, O evangelist, we lovingly honor you. On this day the Virgin came, goes to the grotto to give birth to the pre-eternal Word in an ineffable manner. Dance for joy, O you inhabited on earth, hearing, glorify, along with angels and with shepherds, him who will daddy appeared as a newborn Christ, the pre-eternal God.
Athenos ημέρον τον προαιωνίον λόγον εν σπηλαίω έρχεται από τεκίν απορρίτως χόρευε οικουμένη ακούτης δίσα δόξασον με τα αγγέλων και των ποιμένων βουληθέντα επωθήνε παιδίων αιών των προαιώνων Θεών.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For you are holy, our God, and to you we give glory, to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Unto the ages of ages.
Holy God, you dwell among your saints, who are praised by the seraphim with a thrice holy hymn, you are glorified by the cherubim, and worshipped by all the heavenly powers. You brought all things out of nothing into being. You created man and woman in your image and likeness, and adorned them with all the gifts of your grace. You give wisdom to our saints, to supplicate, and did not overlook the sinner. You have established repentance as the way of salvation. You have enabled us, your lowly and unworthy servant, to stand at this hour before the glory of your holy altar, and to offer you due worship and praise. Master, accept the thrice holy hymn also from the lips of us sinners, and visit us in your goodness. Forgive our voluntary and involuntary transgressions, sanctify our souls and bodies, and grant that we may worship and serve you in holiness all the days of our lives. By the intercessions of the Holy Theotokos and of all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us.
Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Holy Immortal, have mercy on us.
Agios athanatos eleison imas. Δόξα Πατρί και Υιόν και Άγιο Πνεύματι, και νυν και αΐ, και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Αγίος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Δύναμις.
Δύναμις with conviction.
Αγίος.
He who comes in the name of the Lord, blessed are you on the glorious throne of your kingdom, who is seated upon the cherubim always, now and ever, into the ages of ages. Amen.
Agios athanatos eleison imas.
Blessed are you, O Lord, the God of our fathers, for you are just in all that you have done.
Wisdom.
The reading is from St. Paul's letter to the Hebrews.
Let us be attentive.
Brethren, by faith Abraham sojourned in the land of promise as in a foreign land, living in tents with Isaac and Jacob, heirs with him of the same promise. For he looked forward to the city which has a foundation, whose builder and maker is God. And what more shall I say? For time would fail to tell me of Gideon, Barak, Samson, Jephthah, of David and Samuel and the prophets, who through faith conquered kingdoms, enforced justice, received promises, stopped the mouths of lions, quenched raging fire, escaped the edge of the sword, won strength out of weakness, became mighty in war, put foreign armies to flight. Women received their dead by resurrection. Some were tortured, refusing to accept release that they might rise again to a better life. Others suffered mocking and scourging, and even chains and imprisonment. They were stoned, they were sawn in two, they were killed with a sword. They went about in the skins of sheep and goats, destitute, afflicted, ill-treated, of whom the world was not worthy, wandering over deserts and mountains and in the dens and caves of the earth. And all these, though well attested by their faith, did not receive what was promised, since God had foreseen something better for us, that apart from us, they should not be made perfect.
Peace be with you, the reader.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Shine within our heart, loving Master, the pure light of your divine knowledge, and open our eyes that we may comprehend the message of your gospel. Instill in us also reverence for your blessed commandments, so that having conquered sinful desires, we may pursue a spiritual life at thinking and doing all those things that are pleasing to you. For you, O Christ, are God, the light of our souls and bodies, and you give glory to the eternal Father, and your all-holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever, into the ages of ages. Amen.
Wisdom arise, let us hear the Holy Gospel.
Peace be with you all.
And with your spirit.
The reading is from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Let us be attentive.
Glory to you, O Lord. Glory to you.
The book of the genealogy of Jesus Christ, the son of David, the son of Abraham. Abraham was the father of Isaac, and Isaac the father of Jacob, and Jacob the father of Judah and his brothers, and Judah the father of Perez, and Zerah by Tamar, and Perez the father of Hezron, and Hezron the father of Ram, and Ram the father of Amminadab, and Amminadab the father of Nashon, and Nashon the father of Salmon, and Salmon the father of Boaz by Rahab, and Boaz the father of Obed by Ruth, and Obed the father of Jesse, and Jesse the father of David the king. And David was the father of Solomon by the wife of Uriah, and Solomon the father of Rehoboam, and Rehoboam the father of Abijah, and Abijah the father of Asa, and Asa the father of Jehoshaphat, and Jehoshaphat the father of Joram, and Joram the father of Uzziah, and Uzziah the father of Jotham, and Jotham the father of Ahaz, and Ahaz the father of Hezekiah, and Hezekiah the father of Manasseh, and Manasseh the father of Amos, and Amos the father of Josiah, and Josiah the father of Jeconiah and his brothers at the time of deportation to Babylon. And after the deportation to Babylon, Jeconiah was the father of Shealtiel, and Shealtiel the father of Zerubbabel, and Zerubbabel the father of Abiud, and Abiud the father of Eliakim, and Eliakim the father of Azor, and Azor the father of Zadok, and Zadok the father of Ahim, and Ahim, the father of Eliud, and Eliud, the father of Eleazar, and Eleazar, the father of Mathan, and Mathan, the father of Jacob, and Jacob, the father of Joseph, the husband of Mary, and of whom Jesus was born, who is called Christ. So all the generations from Abraham to David were 14 generations, and from David to deportation to Babylon, 14 generations. And from the deportation to Babylon to the Christ, 14 generations. Now the birth of Jesus Christ took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found to be with child of the Holy Spirit. And her husband Joseph, being a just man and unwilling to put her to shame, resolved to divorce her quietly. But as he considered this, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not fear to take Mary your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had spoken by the prophet, Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and his name shall be Emmanuel, which means God be with us. When Joseph woke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took his wife, but knew her not until she had borne a son, and his name was called Jesus.
Peace be with you, proclaims the gospel in all of you. Again, we bow before you, our loving God, and ask that you hear our prayer, cleanse our souls and bodies from all defilement of flesh and spirit, and grant that we may stand without condemnation before your holy altar. We pray, O Lord, for progress in life, faith, and spiritual discernment to the faithful who pray with us, so that they may always worship you with reverence and love and partake of your holy mysteries without blame or condemnation, become worthy of your heavenly kingdom, and grant that always guided by your power, we may give glory to you.
O posi potu karatu su pandote filathomeni, si doxan anapembomen, to patri ke to io ke to agio pnevmati, νυν και αΐ, και Ιησούς αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν. One bound by worthy desires, worthy to approach, draw near, minister to you, the King of glory. To serve you is great and awesome, even for the angelic powers. But because of your ineffable and immeasurable love for us, you became man without alteration or change. You have served as a high priest and as Lord of all, entrusted to us celebration of this liturgical sacrifice without the shedding of blood. For you alone, Lord our God, rule over all things in heaven and on earth. You are seated on the throne of the cherubim, the Lord of the seraphim, the King of Israel. You alone are holy and dwell among your saints. You alone are good and ready to hear. Therefore, I implore you, look upon me, your sinful and unworthy servant. Cleanse my soul and heart from an evil conscience. Enable me by the power of your Holy Spirit, so that vested with the grace of priesthood, I may stand before your holy table and celebrate the mystery of your holy and pure body and your precious blood. To you I come with bowed head and pray, do not turn your face away from me, nor reject me from among your children, but rather make me your sinful and unworthy servant, worthy to offer to you these gifts. For you, O Christ our God, art is the one who is offered and offered, the one who receives and distributed joy and glory, the eternal Father, in your all holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever, into the ages of ages. Amen.
Having
the resurrection of Christ, let us worship the one holy, the Jesus, the Holy Spirit, the one who bent your cross of grace and grace. According to your abundant mercy, blot out my transgression. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, cleanse me from my sin. Remember my transgressions and my sin is ever before me. Against you, you only have I sinned and done evil in your sight, that you are justified in your sentence and blameless in judgment. Behold, I was brought forth in iniquity and sin that my mother bare me. Behold, you desire truth in the inward being. Therefore, teach me wisdom in my secret heart.
Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Fill my heart with joy and gladness. Let the bones that you have broken rejoice. Hide your face away from my sins and blot out all my iniquities. Create me a clean heart, O God, and put a new right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of the salvation, home with the willing spirit. Then they shall teach transgressors your ways, and sinners shall return to you. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, the God of my salvation. And my tongue will sing aloud of your deliverance, for you will know the sacrifice. Were I to give a burnt offering, you would not be pleased. A sacrifice acceptable, God, a broken spirit. A broken and contrite heart, O God, you will not despise. Do good, O Lord, your good pleasure is thine, and let the walls of Jerusalem be built. Then they shall offer bullocks upon your altar, and have mercy upon me, O God. Have mercy upon me, O God. Have mercy upon me, O God. Sinner, and have mercy upon me. O God, forgive me a sinner, and have mercy upon me. Salvation and call upon the name of the Lord.
That we may receive the King of all, that we may receive the King of all.
Pandonimon Nisi. Κύριος ο Θεός εν τη βασιλεία αυτού πάντοτε νυν και αγί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Πρέβο επετώτες δρέπτε μάρε τώρα λόρ κρέστην σαβά. Pomeniasca Domnem nulle, Dumnezeu intrue un parasia sa, to edia ie, oana cumese, purgase, un veci veci, lore.
Amin.
Gospod, Bog spomienec, venat su carvos voie, sva desadec iu veci usve vecuval.
Amén.
El Señor Dios te acuerde de nosotros, en su reino eternamente ahora y siempre, por los siglos.
Amén.
May the Lord God remember all of you in his kingdom, both now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Invisibly escorted, escorted by the angelic host, by the angelic host, by angelic host.
Then bullocks shall be offered upon your altar, and have mercy on me, O God. May the Lord God remember you are the acronym in his kingdom. May the Holy Spirit come upon you, and may the might of the high overshadow you. May the Lord our God remember you are both the acronyms in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen.
Διπληρώσουμε μεν την δέη συνημών το Κύριο.
Κύριε Λέησον.
Υπέρ το προτεθέντον τιμίων δώρων του Κυρίου δεηθόμεν.
Κύριε Λέησον.
Υπέρ του Αγίου οίκου του και του μεταπίστεως ευλαβίας και φόβου Θείου ισιόντων εν αυτό. Κύριε δεηθόμεν.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Υπέρ του λύσενε μας από πάσης λήψεως, οργής, κινδύνου και ανάγκης, του Κυρίου δεηθόμεν.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Αντιλεβούσον στον ελέησον ή αφυλάξον ημάς ο Θεός, της η χάριτη.
Κύριε ελέησον.
For a perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless day, let us ask the Lord.
Add this, O Lord.
For an angel of peace.
For an angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask the Lord.
Add this, O Lord.
For forgiveness and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For that which is good and beneficial for our souls and for peace for the world, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For a Christian into our lives, peaceful without shame and suffering, and for a good account before the awesome judgment seat of Christ, let us ask the Lord.
Lord, have mercy, O Lord.
Remembering our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Oh, you, O Lord.
Through the mercies of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all-holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and forever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Irini Pasi, peace be with you all.
With your spirit.
Let us love one another, that with one mind we may confess.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, Trinity, one in essence and inseparable.
As we prepare ourselves to read the Nicene Constantinopolitan Creed, it's indeed a blessing that today, and also on Christmas Eve, each of these, we will bring into the faith a family that has been studying and working here at St. Mark. I ask them, please, the Hana family, to please come forward with their sponsors, the Kondoses. Their sons will come out also from the altar, and together they will receive holy chrismation and be chrismated in the faith. O blessed are you, O Christ our God, who by sending down the Holy Spirit upon them made the fishermen wise, and through them illumined the world, and through you the universe was ever drawn. All glory to you, O God. Today, I, by the grace of God, and my own free will, having received proper instruction, changed by the seal of the gift of the Holy Spirit, and accept the Orthodox faith,
and confess before God and man.
Confess before God and man.
That, and then together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate and suffered and was buried. And he rose on the third day according to the scriptures. And he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom will have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshiped and glorified, who spoke to the prophets, in one holy Catholic and apostolic church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen. Repeat after me. I further confess and accept the traditions of the Orthodox Church, through which I seek to be made worthy of becoming a faithful servant of the Lord by keeping His commandments and being pleasing to Him in all things. This I ask through the grace and love of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, to whom is due all glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever, into the ages of ages. Amen. The name you're going to take is just David. The servant of God, Leonidas, is tonsured in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Jonas.
The servant of God, Jonas, is tonsured in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The servant of God, Elena, is tonsured in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Marcus. The servant of God, Marcus, is tonsured in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. As Father Alex places chrism on the sign of the cross upon them, as he says the seal of the gift of the Holy Spirit, we all respond with Amen.
The Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The seal of the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The seal of the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The seal of the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
As we read the final prayer, your sponsors in the faith, your loving friends, the Condos family, Rick and Aaron, and they will give you the crosses for you to put on. O Lord our God, you who have made these your servants worthy to seek spiritual perfection through the Orthodox Christian faith and to receive the seal of Holy Chrism, Lord of all, preserve them in their faith and in you, and grant to them grow in righteousness and adorn them fully with every grace. For you bless and sanctify all things, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Blessed return for a picture.
We welcome them into our beautiful St. Mark Church, and since we're all here, we will all turn around for one picture together. The Holy Spirit indeed working in 2022. May God bless us, and may we all walk toward His faith. Amen. Okay, guys.
Καλώς το μεν μεταφόβου, πρόσκομε την Αγίαν αναφοράν, εν ειρήνη προσφέρειν.
Ελεόν ειρήνης της Υιάν ενέσεων.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit,
let us lift up our hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Ευχαριστήσομεν το Κυρίου, let us give thanks to the Lord.
It is proper and right
to bless you, to praise you, to thank you in all place of your dominion, for you are God ineffable, beyond comprehension, invisible, beyond understanding, existing forever and always the same, you and your only begotten Son and your Holy Spirit. You brought us into being out of nothing, and when we fell, you raised us up again. You did not cease doing everything until you led us to heaven and granted us your kingdom to come. For all these things we thank you and your only begotten Son and your Holy Spirit, for all the things that we know and do not know, for blessings seen and unseen that have been bestowed upon us. We also thank you for this liturgy, which you are pleased to accept from our hands, even though you are surrounded by thousands of archangels and tens of thousands of angels, by the cherubim and the seraphim, six-winged, many-eyed, soaring with their wings, singing the victory hymn, proclaiming, crying out, and saying,
Και
Άγιος, 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 Κύριος Σαββαώθ.
Together these blessed powers, merciful Master, we also proclaim and say, you are holy and most holy and sublime is your glory. You so loved your world that you gave your only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. On the night when he was delivered up, or rather when he gave himself up for the life of the world, he took bread in his holy, pure, and blameless hands, and giving thanks, he blessed, he sanctified, he broke it. He gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying these words, take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you, for the remission of sins. Lavete, faiete, tutto muestito soma, to iperimon colonenon gisafesin amartion. Drink of this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Πείτε εξ αυτού πάντας τούτο εστί το αίμα μου, το της καινής διαθήκης, το υπέρ ημών και πολλών εχινόμενων, εις άφεσιν αμάρτιον. Remembering, therefore, this command of the Savior and all that came to pass for our sake, the cross, the tomb, the resurrection on the third day, the ascension into heaven, the enthronement at the right hand of the Father, and the second and glorious coming again.
Τα εσά εκ των σών σοι προσφέρομεν κατά πάντα και διά πάντα.
We offer to you these gifts from your own gifts in all and for all. Once again, we offer to you this spiritual worship without the shedding of blood, and we ask, pray, and entreat you, send down your Holy Spirit upon us and upon the gifts you have presented.
Father, bless the holy bread.
And make this bread the precious body of your Christ.
Amen. Amen.
Father, bless the holy cup.
And that which is in this cup, the precious blood of your Christ.
Amen. Amen.
Father, bless both holy gifts.
Changing them by your Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. That they may be those who partake of them for vigilance of soul, forgiveness of sins, communion of your Holy Spirit, fulfillment of the kingdom of heaven, confidence before you and not in judgment, or condemnation. Again, we offer the spiritual worship for those who be fools in the faith, forefathers, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, saints, and for every religious spirit made perfect in our faith.
A Εξαιρετός της Παναγίας ακράντου επερευλογημένης εν δόξου δεσποίνης ημών Θεοτόκου και αι Παρθένου Μαρίας.
For St. John the Prophet, born of the Son, glory of honorable apostles, for Sebastian the Saint, whose men we commemorate, for all your saints, whose men we commemorate, Maximus and Zoe, George, Ben Athanasius, George and Sasha, Son, Ben Athanasius, the priest, Adamus, Ben Athanasius, Socrates, priest, George, Carrie, Cleopatra, Constantine, and grant them less light of our canon shines again. We ask, Lord, you remember all the you brought to teach your word in your truth, all deacons and priests in the service of Christ, and everyone in the holy orders. We also offer to you the spiritual worship the Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, for those living in purity and holiness, permit them, O Lord, to serve and govern in peace, that the faithful conduct of their duties we may live peaceful lives in all piety and holiness.
Remember, Lord, our Archbishop Alexios, grant that he may serve your holy churches in peace. Keep him safe, honorable, and healthy for many years, rightly teaching the word of your truth.
Also remember, Lord, those each of us calls to mind, and all your people.
Remember, Lord, the city in which we live, every city and country, and the faithful who live in them. Remember, Lord, the travelers, the sick, the suffering, the captives, granting them protection and salvation. Remember, Lord, those who do charitable work, who serve in your holy churches, and who care for the poor, and send your mercy upon us all. And we pray, O Lord, for those enduring religious persecution throughout the world, for peace in the Ukraine, for the softening of the hearts of the aggressors. We pray, O Lord, for our brothers and sisters who are still suffering from the effects of Hurricane Ian. And we pray, O Lord, for Eleni, George, Ron, Mary Lubov, Kay, Steve, Danis, Zenovia, Margarita, Gus, Sergio, George, Spiridon, Dawn, Angela, Constantine, Elena, Gary, Kim, Eileen, David, Barbara, June, Peter, Ian, Fortini, Betty Ann, Marina, Evelyn, Michali, Angela, Mary Dax, and Mary Jane. And grant that with one voice and one heart we may praise and glorify your most honored and majestic name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
And the mercy of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, shall be with you all.
And with your spirit.
I greet you with much love and joy in our Lord's name this morning. Allow me to offer just a few brief announcements and to offer a small what we believe. Of course, we know that today is our Christmas pageant, our Christmas party, and a special thank you to all of our Sunday church school staff and children, to Julie, to Mato, and to all of their hard workers who have been working so hard. We have a record number of little ones today, and it will be very exciting. A reminder that today, if you are a young adult home from college, in your 20s, early 30s, and you'd like to join us at the YAL, the Y'all Christmas Social, it'll be at the Beer Garden today. We have our Philoptikos has sponsored a wonderful array of appetizers for us all, and you're all welcome to join us. We do have the sign-up sheet here in the worship guide each and every week, not today, but we ask you all, please join us at our house. Presidente and I, a few months ago, had about 44 young people who showed up, and of course, everyone is welcome, our young adults. The Epiphany Luncheon, I cannot underestimate the importance that today in the church afterwards we'll be selling tickets for the Epiphany Luncheon. His Grace Bishop Sebastian will be with us, and it's his name day today, but he will be with us as we give thanks and bless all of our faithful ministry leads throughout the entire year on that day. And the reason I say it's so important is that next Sunday is Christmas Day. The Sunday after is New Year's Day. We're not going to be having fellowship coffee hours on those days, but rather for all of us to be with our family. So it's important that if you'd like to attend, that you please purchase, and I encourage you, purchase the tickets today. A few moments ago, we were blessed to bring in a family into the faith, the Hana family. And because they were already baptized, we believe in one baptism for the remission of sins, as we say in the creed each and every week. Because they are already baptized in the name of the Trinity,
Therefore, there is no need to re-baptize. We don't believe in that because we believe in one baptism for the remission of sins. So thus, we anoint with chrism. And chrism is different than any holy oil. Chrism is made at the ancient Patriarchate of Constantinople about every 8 to 10 years and is sent throughout all the Orthodox churches in the world. It's made on Holy Thursday during Holy Week, and they spend 3 to 4 days in various prayers preparing the chrism. Chrism, if you think about it, it's oil mixed with myrrh and spices, etc. Oil is very important because oil is a sign of new life. Therefore, when we think about olive oil, we think about the beginning of the chrism, making it. Oil, when Noah was in the ark and there was devastation across the land, he sent out a dove. And the dove came back with an olive twig, which symbolizes new life. So therefore, oil is an important aspect. It's a physical manifestation of something special. So thus, if you look here at our baptism of Christ, and then you see right across away is the icon of the Pentecost when the Holy Spirit came down upon the apostles. And then next to it is the icon of Noah. It all relates together as we baptize and chrismate in the faith. So today, through baptism, we were able to take this, the beautiful blessing of Holy Chrism and anoint in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Tonsuring by taking a little piece of hair as their sign of obedience to Jesus Christ in the faith. That's a beautiful aspect of our faith that many of us don't get to experience when we're adults because we do it as children. But it's a beautiful thing, and thus when we anoint, we say the seal of the gift of the Holy Spirit, and we all respond amen to affirm that the Holy Spirit today has come upon the beautiful Hana family, the Kondoses, their sponsors, and all of us. May the Holy Spirit continue to work beautiful miracles, I would say, in this world because we need it. Amen.
Having commemorated all the saints, again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the precious gifts here presented and consecrated, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That our God, who loves mankind, having accepted at his holy celestial and mystical altar as an offering of spiritual fragrance, may return send down upon us the divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
Having asked for the unity of faith and for the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life unto Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
Και κατεξίωσον ημάς δέσποτα με τα παρησίας ακατακρίτως τολμάν επικαλείστε σε τον επουράνιον Θεό Πατέρα και λέγειν Πάτερ ημών ο εν της ουρανής αγιαστήτω το όνομά σου ελθέτω η βασιλεία σου γεννηθήτω το θέλημά σου ως εν ουρανό και επί της γης τον άρτον ημών των επιούσιων δώσε μην σήμερα και άφησε μην τα ωφελήματα ημών, ως και εμείς αφήμεν τους φελέτες ημών. Και εμείς ενήγης ημάς εις πειρασμόν, αλλά ρίσε ημάς από το πονηρού.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For yours the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Irene posse, peace be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us bow our heads. lives to the Lord.
To you, O Lord.
Master, look down from heaven upon those of us who are here who have bowed our heads before you. For we have not bowed before flesh and blood, but before you, the awesome God. Therefore, Master, guide the course of our life for our benefit according to the need of each of us. Sail with those who sail, travel with those who travel, heal the sick, physician of our souls and our bodies.
By the grace, mercy, and love for us of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us be attentive, proskuma.
Desire the holy gifts for the holy people of God.
Break, Master.
The Lamb of God is broken and distributed, broken yet not divided, forever eaten, never consumed, sanctified those who partake of it. Jesus. The cup is filled with the faith and the Holy Spirit. Amen. God, forgive me, a sinner, and have mercy upon my brothers. Forgive me, my brothers and sisters. Forgive me, Mark, and worthy priest. Behold, I approach Christ, our immortal King and our God, the precious body of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ. Forgive me, Mark, and worthy priest. Present blood. Amen. As you touch my lips, my sins are forgiven, and my guilt is taken away. Christ is born. Christ is born. Glory. I should have announced earlier, and forgive me, that once we have the opportunity to receive the body and blood of Christ, we ask our Sunday church school children to go first, and as they receive then, to quickly go as fast as they can upstairs, that our team is up there waiting for them. I can see already in the rafters, they're getting ready to prepare them for our Christmas pageant. Also, if you are here today and you would like to become a steward of our church, we had Stewardship Sunday a few weeks ago, and that if those, we have a limited edition of our St. Mark Boca icons that are given out for those who make their stewardship pledge in December. So if you haven't done so yet, there are still a few more weeks. There are cards in your pews, and there's a table in the back of the church. From time to time, we have beautiful moments that overtake us with joy and love in His name. There are different moments in the history of the church, in the history of mankind. From the time God created the first people in the Garden of Eden, God began speaking to all people. For over 1,000 years, God had been speaking and revealing Himself to different people at different times and different places. He spoke to Moses as he wrote the first five books of the Bible. He gave Psalms to David. He gave Proverbs to Solomon and prophecy to prophets. For over one millennia, God had spoken practically nonstop. Then, when the last prophet, and his name was Malachi, wrote his last words and put down his pen or whatever writing instrument he used, God, for the first time in over 1,000 years, went silent. For the longest period of time since Moses was alive, God did not say anything else to anyone. He did not inspire. He did not reveal his teachings for the scriptural writers to put down. For over 400 years, there was nothing but dead silence. Then after 4 centuries, God opens his mouth and speaks. And what is the very first thing that he says? The very first thing he has someone write down? A family tree. A genealogy, or today, what we would call a mosaic. In reality, what a family tree is, a picture of a family made up of many individuals called ancestors and descendants. We all have them. In the first gospel writer,
a man named Matthew, who is writing a book about Jesus Christ, begins with all things a genealogy. And this is our reading today. Although sometimes, I have to admit, when reading a genealogy, it can be a little boring. I want to challenge your thinking this morning. Genealogies aren't really boring. They're absolutely fascinating if they meet one criteria. Do you know what that is? If it's your genealogy. And let me explain. If you found on your doorstep tomorrow your family tree that went back the last 2,000 years, I guarantee you would be excited and interested. Genealogies aren't boring. In reality, boring is somebody else's genealogy. But when you really dig into genealogies, into the Bible, they are not boring, they are fascinating. You learn that genealogies are roadmaps. They are roadmaps of how God has moved in the life of your ancestors, for thousands of years. And it is the reason that you are who you are. As we look at the genealogy read this morning, that we read each year, the Sunday before Christmas, keep in mind that Matthew was a Jewish tax collector, and this book was written for Jewish people. For centuries, the Jewish people had been eagerly awaiting and anticipating the birth of the Messiah, who would become their king. This Messiah had been the number one topic of conversation of the prophets for hundreds of years, and every Jewish rabbi had to be an expert in understanding messianic prophecy. It is no wonder that the very first verse of the New Testament reads like this: the record of the genealogy of Jesus the Messiah, the son of David, the son of Abraham. Any rabbi, any Jewish person, any student of the Old Testament would have looked at this verse and said, this is what it all comes down to. God had promised a Messiah who would be a king. You see, a king has to prove his right to the throne by succession. A king does not come to rule by ballot, but by birth. And that is why you read the last name of the genealogy as this: Jacob was the father of Joseph, the husband of Mary, by whom Jesus was born, who is called the Messiah. Everything from Genesis to Malachi was for one purpose: that Jesus Christ, God's Son, the King, the Messiah, the Savior of the world, might be born. Nobody is an accident. You are who you are, and I am who I am, because God chose us to be that person so that we might fit into His plan for us and His plan for the world. God had promised that from the very beginning, that the Messiah had to come through a certain bloodline. Specifically, the Messiah had to come through the family of Abraham, the tribe of Judah, and the house of David. We read that today. The family of Abraham, the tribe of Judah, and the house of David. Abraham, Judah, and David are all names listed in the verses of the genealogy. Any claim to the royal priesthood in Israel, or any claim to the royalty, had to be verified by this genealogy. Anyone could claim to be the Messiah, but they would be rejected if they could not prove they had a direct line to King David himself. All of the begats that we read a few moments earlier when Deacon John was reading all that litany of names, all of those are for a reason. God had made a promise all the way back in the Garden of Eden that a Messiah would come from a woman. Thus, he would be a human being. Through the family of Abraham, thus he would be Jewish. Through the tribe of Judah and the family of David. So he could be both Messiah and king. All of the Old Testament, in over 400 years of history, God was busy keeping his name, keeping his promise, filling out the family tree of Jesus, and making sure every little branch fit perfectly. God saw to it that every marriage and every child produced by that marriage was going to result ultimately in the birth of the Jewish Messiah and the King, Jesus Christ. Think about it. You didn't choose your ancestors. Neither did I. God did. You and I didn't choose one link in the chain that resulted in our birth. God did. We are born in His image and we grow in His likeness. You can know just by your birth and unique identity, God has a special plan in your life. This Christmas, the world will look back 2,000 years to the single event of the birth of the baby named Jesus Christ. But for more than 4,000 years, people living on the other side of that birth, the other side, look forward to the same event. How amazing is that? We are both looking forward and now we are looking back. The birth of Jesus Christ was no accident. It was not the result of chance. It was the result of choice. It was not because of human faith. It was because of divine force. The next time you wonder whether or not the world is spinning out of control, as I do often, the next time you feel hopeless, helpless, and confused, scared or indifferent, really, just read the first verse of the first chapter of the first book of the New Testament. Remember, God has a hand in all things, and His will governs all. Just like Jesus, you and I are the result of this beautiful genealogy, this mosaic, this amazing genealogy. Before you and I were even born, God was overseeing the future, putting the pieces together, choosing us so we could fit into His plan. This is not predestination because we have a choice, but He can see from the past, the present, to the future and see it all. Why did God use all these people that you read in the family tree? He didn't have to. He could have just left Jesus on somebody's doorstep, but instead, He did it through the mosaic of people like you and me. It is just as if God was saying to the entire world, just like I said I would do it, I did it. The mosaic is complete. The picture is perfect. The masterpiece is finished. The Messiah has come. Christ is born. Glorify Him. Now we have an opportunity to be part of this mosaic, His genealogy that He is putting together, even now called His family. And you can be part of God's family tree. Christ is born, glorify Him. Today I challenge you to live your life recognizing your genealogy. Through our baptism and chrismation, we are all God's children. We are all born again through His love. We are all descendants of Him. Christ is born. This is a high calling and a high responsibility. Christ is born. Don't sit back and wait for it. Don't. Be active in your faith. Strive for truth on a daily basis. Grow closer to Him each and every day. Wake up giving thanks to God for all of His blessings. Be intentional in how you practice that faith. Christ is born. Glory. Living intentionally through the incarnation. That is how we honor our past. That is how we live in the present, and that's how we look toward the second coming of Christ. This is the real message of the Nativity season of Christmas. Christ is born. Christ is born. May the risen Christ be with each and every one of us always. Amen. I believe and confess, Lord, that You are truly the Christ, the Son of the living God, who came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the first.
I also believe that this is truly Your pure body and this is truly Your precious blood. Therefore, I pray to You, have mercy upon me and forgive my transgressions, voluntary and involuntary, in word and deed, known and unknown, and make me worthy without condemnation to partake of Your pure mysteries for the forgiveness of sins and for life eternal. Amen. How shall I, who am unworthy, enter into the splendor of Your saints? If I dare to enter the bridal chamber, my clothing will accuse me, since it is not a wedding garment, and being bound up, I shall be cast out by the angels. In Your love, Lord, cleanse my soul and save me. Loving Master, Lord Jesus Christ, my God, let not these holy gifts be to my condemnation because of my unworthiness, but for the cleansing and sanctification of soul and body and the pledge of the future life and kingdom. It is good for me to cling to God and to place in him the hope of my salvation. Receive me today, Son of God, as a partaker of your mystical supper. I will not betray your mysteries to your enemies, nor give you a kiss as did Judas, but as the thief, I confess you. Remember me, Lord, in your kingdom.
Μεταφόβου Θεού πίστεως και αγάπης προσέλθετε.
With the fear of God, with faith, love, draw near.
Six. exalt his name together. I sought the Lord and he answered me, and from all my fears he set me free.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise be ever on my lips. My soul will glory in the Lord. Let the lowly hear and be glad. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Look to him and be radiant, that your faces may blush in shame. With the poor cry out, the Lord hears them and rescues them from all their distress.
When Lord bless the Lord at all times, his praise be ever on my lips. My soul will glory in the Lord. Let the lowly hear and be glad.
To rescue him, taste and see that the Lord is good.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise be ever on my lips. My soul will glory in the Lord. Let the lowly hear and be glad.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise will ever be on my lips. My soul will glory in the Lord. Let the lowly hear and be glad.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise be ever on my lips. My soul will glory in the Lord. Let the lowly hear and be glad. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Save, O God, your people and bless your inheritance. Os no theos to laon su, ke vloison tin kryonomian su.
We have seen the true light, we have received the heavenly spirit, we have found the true faith, worshiping the undivided Trinity.
Be exalted, O God of heaven, that your glory be over all the earth. Be exalted, O God above the heavens, that your glory be over all the earth. Blessed is our God, always, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Arise, having partaken of the divine, holy, pure, immortal, heavenly life, Kronos, the mysteries of Christ, let us worthily give thanks to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
O Lord, have mercy.
Having prayed for a perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless day, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life unto Christ our God.
To you, Lord.
We thank you, loving Master, benefactor of our souls, that on this day you have made us worthy once again of your heavenly and immortal mysteries, your precious body and blood. Direct our ways in the right path. Establish us firmly in your fear. Guard our lives and make our endeavor safe through the prayers and supplications of the glorious Theotokos and ever-Virgin Mary and of all your saints. For you are our sanctification, and to you we offer glory, to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us depart in peace.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, bless those who praise you and sanctify those who trust in you. Save your people and bless your inheritance. Protect the entire body of your church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of your house. Glorify them in return by your divine power, and do not abandon us who hope in you. Grant peace to your world, to your churches, to the clergy, to those in public service, to the armed forces stationed throughout the world, and to all your people. For every good and perfect gift comes from above, from you, the Father of lights, whom we glorify, thank, and worship, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Christ our God, you are the fulfillment of the law and the prophets. You have fulfilled the dispensation.
Blessed is the name of the Lord, both now and to the ages. Tono makiriu evlogimenon apotunin keos tu eono.
We pause and offer memorial prayers. A one-year memorial for Tatina Charatsis. A one-year memorial for Mary Tamaris. A two-year memorial for Katina Pappas. And a five-year memorial for Calliope Minoulis. May our Lord Jesus Christ give each of them eternal rest in his kingdom.
Μεταφρεμά του ανδικαίων τα τελειωμένων, τα στριχάς των δούλων σου, σώτεραν άπαυσον, φυλάτων αυτάς, εις την μακαρίαν ζωήν την παρασύ φιλάνθρωπε.
Place of rest, O Lord, where all your saints repose, give rest to the souls of your servants, for you alone are immortal.
Ξαπατρίκα Υιό και Αγίο Πνεύματι, Συ ο Θεός ημών ο κατά βάσης άδειν και τάσο δύνας λύσας των πεπαιδημένων, αυτός και τα σύχας των δούλων σου σώτεραν άπασον.
And forever to the ages of ages, amen. O only pure and immaculate virgin who gave birth to God in virginity, pray for the salvation of the souls of your servants.
Saints, give rest, we pray, O Christ, to the souls of your servants, where there is no more pain, no more suffering, but life everlasting.
Μετά τον Αγίον ανάπασον Χριστέ τας ψυχάς των δούλων σου.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray to you, hear us, and have mercy.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison.
Again, we pray for the rest of the souls of God's servants, Tatina, Mary, Katina, and Calliope, who have fallen asleep, and for the forgiveness of all their sins, both voluntary and involuntary.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
May the Lord God place their souls where the righteous repose. Let us ask for the mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and the remission of their sins from Christ, our immortal King and God.
At this, O Lord,
let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For you, O God of spirits and of all flesh, you trampled upon death and abolished the power of the devil and given life to your world. Give rest, O Lord, to the souls of your servants, Satina, Mary, Katina, Calliope, who have fallen asleep. In a place of light, in a place of comfort, in a place of refreshment, where there is no pain, sorrow, or suffering. As a good and loving God, forgive every sin which they have committed, whether in word or deed or thought. For there is no person who lives and does not sin except for you, the only sinless one. Your righteousness is eternal righteousness, and your word is truth.
Όν εμνημονεύσαμε, Χριστέ ο Θεός ημών, και εσύ την δόξαν αναπέμπομεν, συν τον Άρχο σου Πατρί, και το Παναγίο και Αγαθό και Ζωπιό σου Πνεύματι, νυν και Άγιοι, και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
For you, O Christ, our God of the resurrection, the life and the repose of your departed servants who have fallen asleep, and to you we give glory together with your eternal Father and your all-holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
May your memories be eternal, our dear brothers and sisters, worthy of blessedness and eternal memory.
May your memory be eternal, our dear brothers and sisters, worthy of blessedness and eternal memory.
Blessing of the Lord and his mercy come upon you through his divine grace and love for us always, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to you, our God, our hope, glory to you. May Christ, our true God, who rose from the dead as a good, loving, and merciful God, have mercy upon us and save us through the intercessions of his most pure and holy mother, the power of the precious and life-giving cross, the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, the supplications of the honorable glorious prophet and forerunner John the Baptist, the holy, glorious, and triumphant martyrs, our holy and God-bearing fathers, of St. Mark the Evangelist, the patron saint of our church, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of St. Sebastian, whose memory we commemorate today, and of all your saints. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us. Διευκόν τον Αγίον Πατέρων ημών, Κύριε Ιησού Χριστέ, ο Θεός, ελέησον και σώσον ημάς. May the Holy Trinity protect and keep all of you. Amen. Please be seated. This is a day that the Lord has made. Let us all rejoice and be glad in it. At this point, our faithful workers and helpers are getting ready for the beautiful Christmas pageant that our young people have been preparing for, from the littlest to the oldest. It's indeed such a blessing always. We are going to begin very momentarily. I can see they're already in the back, and we're going to start very soon.
here? Are you looking?
O come, all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. O come ye, O come ye to Bethlehem. O come and behold him, born the King of angels. O come, let us adore.
The hope of the Hebrew people for a Messiah echoed through the centuries. God reveals a sign to Isaiah. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son and call his name Emmanuel.
How will he come? When will he come? Where will he come?
It is coming this way. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered for the census. All went to their own town to be registered.
Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child.
Micah's words were about to be fulfilled. You, O Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, from you shall come forth one who shall rule Israel.
O little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark streets shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight.
In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified.
The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord."
And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among people of goodwill."
Hark, the herald angels sing, "Glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies, with the angelic host proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King."
So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told to them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them.
Isaiah said of old, "Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn."
They shall bring gold and frankincense, and shall proclaim the praise of the Lord. Magi kings from the east came riding through the desert sands and over towering mountains.
"We three kings of Orient are bearing gifts. We traverse afar, field and mountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light."
They saw the star, the same one they had seen in the east, and it went before them until it stopped over the place where the child was.
They went into the house and saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and worshipped him. Then, opening their treasure chest, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
"Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace.
For the custom of giving gifts on Christmas Day began with the wise men. For centuries, people have followed this practice as an indication of their joy over the Lord's birth and the beginning of our salvation.
We too are called upon to offer gifts to our Lord on the day of his birth. We are called upon him to give ourselves to him, to dedicate our hearts to him.
The story of the little drummer boy plainly teaches us how we should give of ourselves to the Lord. The little drummer boy was playing his drum on a street at Bethlehem on the night that Jesus was born. He sees people carrying gifts and rushing towards the same part of town.
The young boy follows the crowd to the stable. He accepts the royal birth without question. The little poor boy wants to give the baby king a gift together with the others, but he does not have one.
He suddenly gets an idea and asks, "Baby Jesus, I am a poor boy too. I have no gift to bring that's fit to give our king. Shall I play for you on my drum?"
His gift was from a pure heart. He offered his best. It was accepted and rewarded with a smile. The little boy's gift is accepted together with those of priceless treasures.
Come, they told me, ba-rum-bum-bum-bum, a newborn king to see, ba-rum-bum-bum-bum, our finest gifts we bring, ba-rum-bum-bum-bum, to lay before the king, ba-rum-bum-bum-bum, rum-bum-bum-bum, rum-bum-bum-bum. So to honor him, ba-rum-bum-bum-bum, when we come.
Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart.
Truly, my son, the prayer of my troubled heart is now fulfilled with your coming. For here, through faith, is born the Son of God, Emmanuel, the child of hope and peace.
Christ is born, glorify him. Christ comes from heaven, receive him.
Christ is on earth, praise him. All the earth, sing to the Lord.
All you people, sing praises and gladness, for he has been glorified.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace on earth to people of goodwill.
Praise to the Lord this holy night.
Holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh, hear the angel voices, oh, night divine. Christ was born, oh, night divine, oh, night divine.
Parents, if parents want to come take pictures, please do. 31 angels, 11 sheep, 9 shepherds, Mary, Joseph, 3 wise men and some girls, Isaiah, the prophet, the little drummer boy, God bless you. I'll ask them to be brought out the sides while they take a little picture here, and we're going to dismiss the children first. I did hear some sleigh bells earlier, and I want you to know, I believe somebody might be making a visit in the hall today. I heard, I'm not sure. And also, for those parents who want to catch the end of the World Cup, it'll be on in the hall too. Yeah. Shh. God bless you all. Did you take a picture?
Thank you.